Welcome to Marine Tech Hub. Today I want to tell very important thing with respect to the battery. Okay, whether you are using this battery for the lifeboat or for the emergency generator or anywhere for your bike or the car. Very important thing. While you are measuring the voltage with the multimeter, it will normally show you 12 volt if it is 12 volt battery. Sometimes battery is bad, then it will show less volt. By just checking the voltage, we are not sure whether the battery is good or bad unless we are giving a load test. Okay, so just lifeboat is not starting, electrical officer coming and reporting, sir, battery voltage is good, but maybe the lifeboat not starting. So for that we have to do the load test, very important. But if you are having a HRD meter, high resistance discharge meter, on board the ship, if you are having, it's very good. So we can do the load test with that meter. If you are not having, superintendents can order and all the ships can have that HRD meter. Otherwise, what you have to do is, you have to do a real load test by starting the generator or the lifeboat. Keep the multimeter with the DC, you can see the voltage, then while starting the voltage will drop. Okay, this is one important thing. One more thing which I want to tell you is, what happened was, my car had a problem with starting. So after 3 months I come from the ship and I started, not starting. So I thought that okay, the battery has gone down. So voltage we checked, so battery was not good enough. So I connected, I usually have a jumper with me in my car, and I connected a new battery with the car for starting. Normally we put positive negative and new battery, you can take this connection from the other car or you can keep another battery with you and start. So while with new battery also it was not starting, then I was thinking what is went wrong, because the cable which I was using was last 5 years I was using the same cable. Then I was not able to start, then again I put some other battery, new one, again it's not starting. Then I was getting frustrated, then I called the service guy. He also did the thing, but the car, my car was not starting. Then this guy was saying, sir, your cable may be weak. Okay, so then I fabricated a new cable with a thicker thing and it started. So there is always a possibility that the battery is good, but your cable may be weak, it's not transmitting that much of current. So the fault can lie there also. Suppose your emergency generator is not starting and the starting motor is good, the battery looks to be good on load, but it's not starting because it's not drawing the enough current through your cable. So there is always a possibility that your cable quality is not good, so it's not drawing enough current. Okay, so today this is my important thing which I want to convey to you. The battery, do a load test, and if the battery is good, the cable can also be weak. So you have to keep a spare cable on the boat, spare cable required for the emergency generator. If you have, keep one, and even like you have in the incinerator on a spark, like you have a 10,000 volt. So when you are using a 10,000 volt for creating a spark for your pilot burner and all, these are special cables. So that is very important. Okay, I will run the video for you, and if you really feel that this video is useful, comment on it, subscribe on it. I hope all engineers on board the ship take the advantage of this video and give me a feedback. Okay, I'll run the video for you. Welcome to Marine Tech Hub. Today I'll be explaining you about how you're going to check the battery condition of a diesel generator. In this picture you can see right now the voltage of each battery is checked. We got two batteries of 12 volts each. So the supply which is coming from the charger will be 26 volts.
So the first battery we can check, it is showing 13 volt. The other battery will also show 13 volts, but when you remove the terminal, the voltage will be less. In real scenario, we have to check the battery condition by starting the generator. So voltage should not dip too much. If it's dipping too much, that means the condition of the battery is not good. So in this our condition case, you can see the first battery is 13 volt, second battery also showing 13 volts. That means the charger voltage is coming total 26 volts. So now you can see the total voltage coming from the charger is 26. So condition of the battery we will check by starting the generator. So in this case the battery condition is still okay. So the voltage dip is not so much. This is the Cummins generator here. So any generator you can do this test, so that you know the health condition of the battery. So I will be starting the generator here now. The voltage will dip. So if the voltage is, if it dips too much, then the condition of the battery is not good. So you see the voltage has dipped to 15 here. So after once the voltage comes back, then you will have the normal voltage here. So once the generator starts, the voltage will be back. So if it dips say 13 or 12, that means the condition of your battery is not good. So this is very important. So whenever you have a problem like this, you always start the generator every day one time and take it on load, and you can check the charger whether it's working. Battery voltage may show sometimes okay, but you do the real test by taking it on load also once in a time, and when you start the generator, the voltage will dip. So if the voltage is dipping too much, then your battery condition is not good, so you need to change the battery. So if you have any doubt regarding this, you can message me. Thank you.